السلام عليكم شيخ.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلاً ومرحباً.
شيخ, the other day I was listening to a lecture and the speaker was sitting on the minbar. He claimed that Amir al-Mu'mineen عليه الصلاة والسلام for 30 years stayed in his house after the martyrdom of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, and that he did not move against Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. Is this true?
Ahsantum, first of all, we have to look at the speaker himself. He is not a direct source for us. We have to go back to the narrations of the Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam. Did this speaker really study the books of the Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam? For example, Kitab Sulaym ibn Qais al-Hilali, which is at the moment the oldest history book in Tashayyu and Shi'ism, which is from the first century. Our Imams alayhum as-salam, they have praised this book, the book of Sulaym ibn Qais al-Hilali. If we go back to this book and we read this book in detail, we will find that Amir al-Mu'mineen Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, he attacked Umar ibn al-Khattab and he broke his nose and he put his face on the ground. So this is what Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam did, first of all. And secondly, also Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi, when he saw the second tyrant Umar ibn al-Khattab on the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he said to Umar ibn al-Khattab, go away from the minbar of my grandfather, O liar, you are a liar. So Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam took Umar down, and Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam called Umar a liar. And also, if we look at all our Imams, from Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi, from As-Siddiqah al-Kubra Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, she did takfir on Abu Bakr and Umar. She said, قَاتِلُوا أَئِمَّةُ الْكُفْرِ. Our fourth Imam, Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, said that Abu Bakr and Umar are two kuffar. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam said that Abu Bakr and Umar killed him. Our ninth Imam, Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam, said that he wished to burn them. He wished to burn them. So this is what our Imams alayhi salam clearly said about Abu Bakr. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam attacked Umar ibn al-Khattab, and our Imams alayhi salam have clearly dissociated from Abu Bakr and Umar. So the Shia youth, they can choose. Do they want to follow the Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam? Well, this is the path of the Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam, to dissociate from Abu Bakr and Umar. Do they want to follow the path of our scholars from the time of Ibn Jibrin al-Qumni, from the time of Shaykh al-Mufid, al-Allama al-Halabi, Ibn Shahr Ashub, until the scholars of today, they all dissociate from Abu Bakr and Umar. If we want to follow this path, then we should dissociate from Abu Bakr and Umar. If we want to sell our religion for this dunya, if we want to leave the message of As-Siddiqah al-Kubra, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, then they can go and praise Abu Bakr and Umar, but they should not say that they are the Shia of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, because Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam exposed them. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam dissociate from them. Our eighth Imam, Imam al-Rida alayhi salam, in the book Safat al-Shia of Shaykh al-Saduq rahmatullahi alayhi, in one of the narrations, the Imam is saying that one of the signs of a believer is dissociating, is doing tabarri from the enemies of the Ahlul Bayt alayhum salam. And if we look at the enemies of the Ahlul Bayt alayhum salam, the worst two are Abu Bakr and Umar.
Ahsantum, Shaykh.
Ahsallahu alayhi.